Hi, I'm Sarah McRae. I'm an aquatic endangered species biologist with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service in Raleigh, North Carolina. Today I'm working with the Tar River Spiny Mussel, which is a freshwater bivalve mussel found in the Piedmont streams in North Carolina. It's found nowhere else on Earth except for the Tar River Basin and the Neuse River Basin. Freshwater mussels live in streams and to eat and to breathe, they filter the water and they siphon in all of the water and all of the particles, and they gather food and they clean our streams. And like the stream behind me where we collected these individuals, they are cleaning the system. Tar River spiny mussel is a very rare, critically endangered species, and we believe that it was almost extinct in the wild, and we captured a few and brought them into captivity, and we're working with the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission and NC State University to figure out ways to propagate the species and put more out into the wild.
In 2008, we surveyed these different locations for Tar River spiny mussel to collect adult broodstock. We then took those adults to our hatcheries, and in a project that was collaborating with Fish and Wildlife Service and the North Carolina State University to see if we could grow them out. And our overall plan is to to restock these animals out into the wild to try and restore ecosystem services such as clean water.
I'm at the Conservation Aquaculture Center at the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission Fish Hatchery in Marion, North Carolina. This is where we are propagating and growing Tar River spiny mussels. They're being fed by water pumped into the building from the pond behind me.
The purpose of this project in fishing in Little Fishing Creeks is to determine how propagated mussels will fare once they're stocked out into the wild. We took two-year-old mussels, put them in wire mesh cages in each of these two streams back in April of this year, 2012, and monitored those cages through the year. And today, we've come out to the streams to pull the cages from the water and assess the mussels. And from there, we'll measure survival and also how much they've grown over the course of the year. And that will tell us the relative health of the mussels, whether they're growing. We want to know that the mussels will grow and thrive once they're placed out into the stream. And preliminary results suggest that they are doing well, they have grown, and that's good news.
Threats to these mussels, as well as many other aquatic species that live in Piedmont streams in North Carolina, are habitat degradation from sedimentation, which is basically dirt running off the land into the creeks from development or agricultural fields coming straight up to the edge of the streams, or when cattle access streams. When it rains, the dirt just washes into the streams and it can suffocate the mussels. Impounding caused by dams that we put up for water supply, that's a big threat because it changes a riverine environment into a lake environment, and the mussels that need the fast flowing water can't survive in that. Water quality issues from pollution, from discharges actually being discharged into our rivers, or from pollution coming washing off of the roads into the streams. And things like water quantity, which we've got a lot of low flow issues with droughts and manipulating. We tend to, with all of the dams, we manipulate the flows, and that can impact mussels as well. So we're working with our partners to try to prevent these threats and help the Tar River spiny mussel get off the endangered species list.